Welcome to today's Hoopcast. Pat Dooley and Kevin Brockway of the Gainesville Sun, and we're going to talk a little bit about Florida's win at Vanderbilt and preview the game against Georgia coming up on Wednesday night. And Kevin, you were there, I wasn't. It sounded like the Gators really got caught fire.
Yeah, you know, it was interesting. I had a chance to walk around a little bit at the pregame shoot-around and just kind of watch. And you could see some of the guys were pretty locked in. In particular, Chandler, I was watching him a lot and his mannerisms and the way he went about it. And, you know, shoot-arounds are kind of tricky because you could see guys shoot very well and then they go in the game and they clank some. But this was certainly a game where everyone, you know, before the game looked like they were shooting the basketball very well, and obviously carried over into the game with 12 three-pointers being the record at UF. And that's how crazy this team is. This team, I guess, against Southern Utah, came within 10 seconds of being the first team, you know, since 1994 not to make a three in a game, and they, you know, get a school record 12 in the first half. It's kind of their perimeter shooting is consistently inconsistent.
Well, and to me, that's what they are. They are a team when they shoot threes well. They could beat, I don't want to say anybody, I don't think they could beat Duke, but when they shoot threes well, they'd certainly beat anybody in this conference, and they're a good team. They're an NCAA team. When they don't, they still don't really do all the little things necessary at times to get it done. But the bottom line is they did shoot them well, and that was a much-needed win. What happened Wednesday night to go up there? And I know, look, Vanderbilt, I've watched them play a lot this year. They're not very good. And with Ogilvie having the plantar fasciitis in his heel just makes it that much worse. But still, you know, mentally, you just wondered if this team would show up on Sunday.
Yeah, and, you know, last year, you know, when they had their first SEC loss on the road, they quickly followed that up with their second. You know, they had that two-in-a-row stretch. So for them to kind of bounce back in this kind of fashion with two in a row on the road maybe says a little bit about them and about their character and about their maturity, maybe that they didn't have a season ago.
Yeah, I talked to Chandler on Monday and to Billy as well. And, you know, obviously what they're trying to get him to understand is why are you missing? Not that you're missing, but why are you missing? And he's worked awfully hard on his mechanics. And it'll be curious to see if he gets a chance to make a big free throw down the stretch, because, you know, you get the sense he wants to do that. He wants that opportunity again after that big miss at South Carolina.
Yeah, and I think that, you know, he went through the mechanics before, you know, against in December against Wofford, and, you know, he had it for a little while, and then he kind of lost it again. So it'll be interesting to see, you know, if he sticks with it and if he's able to do it for a prolonged stretch. Obviously, 7 of 8, though, that's the kind of afternoon that, you know, it's pretty much a Lee Humphrey-like afternoon. I think that was the most recent since Humphrey in that South Carolina game a few years ago. To have seven in a game is pretty, and a few with a hand in his face as well. They weren't all wide open.
Kind of reminded me of Pat Dooley at the Gainesville Health and Fitness Center every once in a while. You know, you get that hot streak going, the ball just finds you. But, yeah, certainly a big win, and for this team, especially in this conference, to be in the situation they're in. They're right where they were last year, as you know, Kevin. And first of all, those of you who are looking at bracketology and trying to figure things out, it's like preseason polls. Okay, preseason football polls. They're nice to look at and they're interesting, but they mean nothing. Nobody knows who's going. Well, Duke's going to go, Connecticut's going to go, Pittsburgh's going to go, but as far as Florida's opportunities, it's all up to them and it's what they do. They're in position, but it's what they do down the stretch. And as Billy's reiterated many times, and we both know, their schedule gets a little bit tougher every game.
Yeah, 4-15 right now, the combined record in the SEC of the teams they face so far. And, you know, Georgia's coming in on Wednesday. They're an 0-4 team. They're struggling. But then after that, you know, you've got at Tennessee,
right.
South Carolina back at home is playing pretty well. They actually beat Ole Miss, so they're 3-2. They have a winning record in the league. And then at Kentucky, you have a bye, but then at Kentucky, I mean, those three teams are 11-3. I think we'll find out a lot more about this team during that stretch.
Absolutely. But they did, you know, at least get through these two road games with a split record, and I know everybody's still lamenting. It's amazing to me, Kevin, how many emails I've gotten from fans that are upset and mad at Billy and think he's just a terrible coach. And I have to keep reminding them that they did win those back-to-back national championships.
You know, I have too, and I just recently posted a blog, and a lot of people thought that Billy wasn't necessarily contrite, but he did address a little bit Friday, and he said, you know, he said in that situation, hey, look, you know, they're not the only ones that have to build about this. I have to build from this too. And,
right.
And he talked about playing people back, but he said something pretty interesting. He said, you know, you play more people back in that situation, a long rebound, guys take a step back. And I think coaches are always worrying about the three, about
exactly.
The longer shot in that situation rather than someone getting beat. So, you know, he wanted everyone matched up man on man. And, you know, he didn't want South Carolina not to have to worry about blocking out. That's why he had the guys at the foul line in that situation. So, tough situation, tough call. But, obviously, you know, Dan Werner, too, we talked to Monday, was obviously very apologetic about the situation as well. He took it probably as hard as Chandler did, and he's been playing pretty banged up the last couple of weeks. And
right.
So, let's see what they learn from this, and let's see how they move on.
Yeah, and I know the analogy's been made to the football team in the Ole Miss game, and I think it's a good one. I don't expect them to beat everybody by 30 the rest of the way out, the way the football team did. But certainly, this is a team that knows what happened last year, Kevin. They know they're in this position and didn't handle it well. And I think that's going to be the interesting thing, starting with Wednesday night's game against Georgia. Georgia's not very good. It's amazing. It almost, the way they're playing this year, it makes it almost more amazing than what they did last year in the tournament. I mean, I was there for the whole thing. It's still the most incredible thing I've ever witnessed, watching that tournament after the tornado in the Georgia Dome, and then Georgia winning it, the least likely team you would have. But just the fact that they won that tournament, and now they're back to where they were.
I think it tells you a little bit about Sunday Outta Gaines and Dave Bliss,
yeah.
Two guys that were seniors that were near the end of their careers that probably played that tournament with a sense of desperation that this was going to be it for them. And Sunday Outta was always a guy I thought that was a very underrated point guard. Was really tough, could rebound the ball well, a New York City kid, kind of like, you know, Irving Walker.
Yeah.
And someone that really played with a lot of moxie in that tournament. And Bliss was a guy that I think probably finally figured things out the last few weeks of his career in terms of how to be
just
a physical low-post guy, you know what I mean? But Albert Jackson was on that team. He's playing okay this year, and they've got a pretty good freshman in Trey Tompkins down low. They're going to present, you know, physically they could present a problem for Florida. It's just a question of whether, you know, they take advantage of it. I don't think John Pelfrey, for example, did a very good job of taking advantage of his physical advantage.
Well, yeah,
against
Washington
Florida.
Had the early fouls, and that hurt him, but you're right.
Yeah.
And that's going to be the interesting thing for Florida. It's a bad matchup. As bad as Georgia is, it's a bad matchup, and then they're big and strong. And what I think Florida's going to have to do is run and as always, make their threes.
Yeah, and press. Again, Georgia has some issues at point guard as well,
mm-hmm.
and bringing the ball up. Zach Swansea and Ware is a freshman. So you can kind of rile those guys a little bit, and I think that's where the main advantage will be is at the guard play. And you know, Nick Calathes, this could set up for a pretty big game for him.
Well, and it's a big game for Florida, but let's face it. Every game the rest of the way is big because for this team, every win is huge in terms of getting to the tournament, and that's what this season really is about, as it was last year. Can they get to the NCAA tournament? What they do there, I think, in my opinion, is almost irrelevant. They've got to get back to the tournament where they were for 9 straight years, and so obviously this is a game you can't let this one get away. It's Georgia. They haven't won a game in the league, and they can't score. That's the other thing. I mean, they had two games in a row in the 40s. Needless to say, they lost them both. But they can't score. They have very little offense. So you've got to be able to hit some threes. You get up on them, and there's not going to – I mean, Dennis Felton, I don't think he's a bad coach. Apparently he's not a very good recruiter because they never seem to have any players.
Yeah, and, you know, he's been hit by a lot of problems, beginning with Lewis Williams, Mercer. You know, Billy Humphrey obviously got suspended this year after numerous brushes with the law. So he's had a hard time, you know, not only getting guys, but I think keeping guys
keeping
as well.
Straight, yeah.
And, you know, he's a guy that's a very no-nonsense guy, and that maybe rubs some of the younger players the wrong way. He's going to ugly it up, I mean, no doubt. I mean, it's going to be a game that's going to be, you know, kind of the antithesis of Vanderbilt, probably in the 60s or the 50s, and he's going to want to play that style. The question is he going to have enough offense to pull it off? And I don't think he does.
Yeah, and I think, you know, Florida's going to be playing with a little bit of confidence, a little bit of that maybe wasn't there earlier in the season just because of that big win at Vanderbilt. And I think they're going to, you know, be focused for this game. And I would expect a pretty big crowd, too. I think the fans maybe that got down on them after that South Carolina loss kind of got rejuvenated with that incredible showing up in Nashville. So Florida-Georgia Wednesday night, 8 o'clock. Yeah, we'll be there.
Yeah, you know, hopefully some people will be out there, too. And it'll be, you know, obviously the only chance to see them because then they go to Tennessee. They got the South Carolina game at home on ESPN. Then go to Kentucky. So not really many home games coming up in the next couple of weeks.
It really bodes well. The back end of the schedule is more home games. So that if they can kind of get through this tough time, they'll be all right. We'll see how they do. Until next time, we'll come to you and tell you what happened in the Florida-Georgia game, although you probably will already know because you read the Gainesville Sun and go on Gatorsports.com. But we'll kind of talk about that and also preview the game at Rocky Top. Until then, Pat Dooley, Kevin Brockway, the Gainesville Sun saying so long from the Sunshine State.